This is retired reflexologist Sheila. Widowed for 8 years, she still has a lust for life and love.
I'm 81 and I do like adventures.
Shedding sequins all over the place.
I was a secretary, a PA, and then I joined a Fleet Street. So I started writing. I went to interview the Beatles.
I said they wouldn't last. I said they were like any other group at that time. Here today and gone tomorrow. That's how I ended my piece. So that's my legacy.
You're looking fantastic.
Thank you. I'm all sparkly.
Very good. I think you're going to get a French kiss tonight.
Do you think so?
Yeah.
I can't look forward to that.
Yeah, take a seat here. Merlin will look after you.
Merlin.
How are you feeling now?
Oh, I've got myself a little bit apprehensive. But that's okay. I made a list of my requirements, my desires.
Oh, wow. Right.
My husband would have wanted me to find someone. He did say to me, don't be on your own, Sheila. Just you find someone to love. You've got a lot of love to give.
Tall. Okay.
Clean fingernails. Important.
Okay.
Feet. Important.
Feet, as in the shoes or the actual feet?
No, look after your feet.
Oh, you don't like beards?
No, I'm not fond of beards.
Hello?
Ticking all but one of Sheila's boxes, 79-year-old boy racer Bev.
My love of my life is jet skiing. I can only go jet skiing for so many hours before I'm crippled, but it's lovely. I love fast cars. I've only just given up motorcycling. I need someone that's the same as me, young at heart. Whether I'll be able to keep up with the person or not, I don't know.
He's a lovely man.
Okay.
I think you would like him.
And towards the end of your life, which I suppose I am, I miss the simple things that a woman can give you, the cuddles and kisses. And the affection.
How are you, Bev?
How do you do?
Good. Your date is here, Bev.
Thank you. Thank you.
Enjoy.
Good evening.
Oh, good evening. Mm. I've been waiting to see you.
You've started already, have you? What is that, anyway?
It's a white wine spritzer.
I'll try one, please.
So you're Bev?
Yeah, Beverly. I hate Beverly.
That's unusual name for a man, isn't it?
Yeah, no, don't tell me.
So what was your mum thinking of?
God knows. I did get a letter once from the hospital and they were asking me to go for a smear test. All the best.
Cheers.